Hi, this is Dr. Jeff Junig from Suboxone Talk Zone and from Fond du Lac Psychiatry, and I'm just checking in. It's been a while since I've put a recording out here on the web, and I don't want people to think that I've dropped off the planet. So, unfortunately, though, this is going to be a commercial announcement, so a little bit of warning here. I'll try to make it brief. You know, I do a number of things on the web. I do my blog, SuboxoneTalkZone.com. I have a forum, SuboxForum.com, and the point of both of those is to educate people about Suboxone. I write at a couple other blogs for similar purposes, teach at the Medical College of Wisconsin, have a radio show. And all of these things are unpaid positions, which I love doing, so I'm certainly not complaining about them. But I do have a couple kids in college, another one who will be going to college. And for those of you who know my personal story, I got started late. You know, I was an anesthesiologist and lost pretty much everything, thanks to my own opiate dependence. And so, regardless of what you'll read, people when they write in angrily about Suboxone doctors, I'm not independently wealthy. So I'm always looking for a way to provide something that would be useful to people, and something that also I could use to justify to myself the time that I spend working on the blogs and on YouTube videos. The tape that I just put together is called "How Long Are You Going to Take That Stuff?" And the subtitle or the subheading is "An Educational Guide for Those Who Love an Addict Taking Suboxone." And in case you can't figure out from the title, the point of it is, if you are on Suboxone and you have someone in your life, a father, a mother, kids, siblings, who are always on your case about, you know, when are you going to stop taking the medication, those of you who know me know that, in my opinion, those who stop taking the medication are usually at significant risk for relapse. And so I don't recommend stopping the medication. I say, you know, if you're doing well in Suboxone, thank heavens for that, and just stay on it and enjoy life. You know, my own addiction occurred at a time before Suboxone, and I was in residential treatment for 3.5 months and aftercare for 6 years after that. So from my perspective, Suboxone is a godsend. What I do in the recording, I talk about the treatment options for opiate dependence. I point out how, first of all, we don't have a number of treatment options for opiate dependence. Residential treatment, especially in young people, has a low success rate. Opiates are different than alcohol in that before getting to a rock bottom, people sometimes die. So I point this out in the recording that, you know, I'm sorry if they don't like a person being on a medication that is something that works at an opiate receptor, but, you know, it beats dying, and it beats what we used to have, which was nothing, really. So I talk about that. I talk about the fact that people on Suboxone are not getting high, but rather they're just feeling normal. I talk about what types of things would be needed before considering stopping Suboxone, in my opinion. And I think that's pretty much it. But it lasts for about an hour. I mean, I do try to cover as much as I can. And I try to keep it understandable as well, because I know it's not geared towards addicts. It's geared towards people who know addicts. So if you're having problems with someone in that area, consider giving this to your mother as a Mother's Day gift, or father as a Father's Day gift, or whatever. It can be played on an MP3 player. You could burn it on a CD. You could send it as an email attachment, and it really, hopefully, it really clarifies some things for people. So it also serves as a donation to me. And if there is something you've learned from my recordings and my YouTube videos, it would be something that I would really appreciate. And I thank you very much for it. If the purchase price, which I think is around $20 or something like that for a 1 hour recording, if that's a little too much, there's a donation button at Suboxone Talk Zone. Again, if you've learned something from something that I've talked about, please consider supporting my work. I promise if I ever get rich, I will stop asking for support. And I think that's about it. To purchase the recordings, go to SuboxoneTalkZone.com, and there's an article about them there. On the right side of the page, I believe there's a link to purchase, but there's also a separate page. I think at the top of the page it says Educational Recordings. You can click on that, and it'll take you to a site where you can purchase it. You can get it on a CD, or you can get an instant download link. I do invite you to come by the blog, which is Suboxone Talk Zone, or the forum, suboxforum.com, and there's chat there. It's not restricted to people on Suboxone. All we ask of people is that they respect each other. We do not put up with people coming on and saying, I'm cleaner than you are, or you really should get off that stuff. We ask that people communicate kind of in the way they do at meetings, where people talk in the first person, you know, here's what worked for me, and that's as directive as we ask people to be. We believe in living and letting live. If you're on methadone, good for you. If you're on Suboxone, good for you. If you're on stone cold sobriety, good for you. Whatever works, because it's really a pain to be an opiate addict, and we all need to support each other. So again, the tape, how long are you going to be taking that stuff or something like that? And at SuboxoneTalkZone.com, thank you very much for your support. I really do appreciate it. Send me an email at info@subox.info if there's any topic you'd like me to cover in the next YouTube recording. And enjoy the rest of your Saturday afternoon. Bye-bye.